Well, so I can tell you the story of this guy. I can't remember his name, but he was a regular monk, and apparently he hopped onto an island and it floated away with him through the ocean. And now he's enlightened. And supposedly he travels the world, travels the oceans on this island. And he is the Buddha patron saint of sailors in Myanmar.
Oh.
So you find him somewhere in most of the temples.
And then he's surrounded by water.
Because this is his float, supposed to be like the symbol of looking to the east of the sun rising.
Ah. There's a little tiny, tiny, tiny stupa.
Okay, so our where we can go adventure has taken a turn for the wet. And it's the rainy season, as you expect. It's pouring rain. So we decided for a Burmese lunch here. We got rice and soup and beef and eggs. And there's more coming.
Di kasatan saying konde. Konde.
Alright, so stop three on the tour de Bago is the Snake Monastery. I didn't know snakes wanted to be monks.
This is what they feed the pythons.
Oh. Wait, what were you saying about the snake?
It's big.
No, say what you said before.
Oh, a snake like that out in the open, not being in a cage, has such a presence to it.
Yeah,
such an energy.
Did like 15 feet of presence.
15 feet of slimy, I'm going to eat you and strangle you presence.
See, my mom, she used to make animals out of paper mache that were like heads, but hang on the wall. And so, this looks very familiar. A little paper mache. Oh, I gotta show her this. That's a paper mache bowl. One of the guest t-shirts. Thank you.
Take about three steps to your right and you'll be in his armpit. I mean, your left. I'm in the armpit of Buddha. Now make a big sniff. Think while you still have me. Move while you still see me. You'll be lost. You'll be so, so.
Yeah, we've come down to maybe our fifth or sixth temple. This one's called Mahanamazeni, and it's like a large stupa with gold on it. And it's been raining. I've never felt more bootyful.
Okay.
And right when he became enlightened, he took his right hand and he touched the earth. And he basically, paraphrasing, he said, I call Mother Earth to bear the witness of my enlightenment.
Hmm.
So he's always, if you see him in that position, he's touching the earth for the witness of his enlightenment. Some people say it translates as dragon, but when I was doing Pali, it just meant like sacred water serpent.
Okay.
Everything's all right,
everything's all
Is that a tree going out the top there?
Yeah.
I love the tiered look. It reminds me of like Borobudur, but with a big penis looking thing on top.
Yeah, look bad. You got the white elephant.
Thank you.